Oh yeah, before we start the video, there are people all over YouTube saying the perfect grilled cheese does not exist. I'm eating my mom's grilled cheese, then what the heck am I eating? It's legit perfect. Oh yeah, and look how many ghosts are up there. Alright, we're about to go up into the most demonic spot in this complex. Wait, did you hear that? Bro, you can talk.
I know. But no, I didn't.
I swear, I heard a skinwalker or something.
Let's go! But yeah, basically, if any animals are acting out of the normal, because they can't morph into humans, or any object, but animals. If any animals are, like, walking on two legs, run. Because
yeah.
That's a skinwalker, because they can morph into animals, and basically that's it. I literally Googled it, and it said, skinwalkers can only morph into animals.
Yeah, people know what skinwalkers are.
Yeah. But I'm just saying it just in case people don't. Because some people don't, like 2-year-olds.
Oh, yeah.
I just start dancing.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that was a dog.
Yeah. The dog just starts walking on two legs.
Scared the crap out of me, though.
Hold to the devil?
Yeah, that's what prairie dogs are doing.
Hold to the devil?
Burrowing down to the pits of hell.
But yeah, if you look over there, see those little lights? That's by the demon box.
Oh yeah, those houses over there. There's this thing in our complex called the demon box. At least that's what we call it. It's more of like a half circle, but we don't like to go in there. Stage 3, which is when if you do more good than bad, you'll get scratched.
Yeah.
So, we're only gonna enter stage 2.
Well, I'm gonna enter stage 1, he's gonna enter stage 2.
Yeah.
And stage 3 is like touching the fence back there.
No, that's stage 4.
Right.
Stage 4 is when if you touch the fence, you'll basically just die.
Yeah.
But if you go over the fence, oh yeah, you're not alive. Let's just say, if you enter stage 4, your body will not be found.
Yeah. But yet, one of our friends went up, touched the fence at nighttime, 3 a.m., and is still alive.
Yeah, he must have done really bad
thing. Yeah. Alright, this is the line crossing stage 0 from stage 1. Now we're in stage 1, you can't really be scratched here.
Yeah, there's only like stage 1
to... Oh wait, there's a D right there, look.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I'm standing in the middle of a demonic circle right now.
Yeah.
I should probably step out of that before I die.
Yeah. And then where's that line for stage 2? Okay. Here? No, that's not the line. There's another demonic circle.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, there's the line for stage 2. Right here. It's basically a line in the dirt.
Which, if you step over here, there's a possibility you'll feel a stinging pain in your back.
Also, and that's the house that... That's the line of houses that we're talking about. And that's the fence way over there.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, I ain't stepping past this because the demons here do not like me.
All right. 3, 2, 1. I'm in.
Yep. And then...
Can I go deeper?
If you want. But yeah, and stage 3 is that little line over there. Stage 2...
Oh.
Yeah, stage 2 is a very small area. Stage 2 is a little line over there. And then stage 4 is the fence, and then stage 5 is past the fence.
Yeah, stage 5, basically you're dead.
Also, we look at all the ghosts over there.
Yeah, those lines of houses, people say they're haunted. The people living there are possessed.
Yeah.
Or they're very demonistic.
Also, if you look over there, there's a lot of bright ghosts. And that's just...
I mean, they could be street lamps.
Yeah, like over there, we know that's street lights.
Let us know down in the comments.
Yeah, because that might be street lights. And I don't know if there's going to be a comment section, but I know those are either street lights or demons.
Yeah.
It's either one or the other.
Yeah.
But yeah, we do this like daily. We might not film it daily, but we do it daily.
Yeah, every time we get a chance.
Yeah, and it has to be a specific darkness to be able to come out here and like...
From 7 to 12 a.m.
Yeah.
That's when most of the mostly harmless ghosts. But like level 60s.
And secret
levels.
Those
come out at 3 a.m.
And level secrets. Those are the invisible ghosts. That literally no one can see, but they can pick you up and literally throw you on the ground.
Yeah, they
any
can,
height.
They can basically pick you up to 80 feet in the air and just drop you and not care.
Yeah. And we're not joking.
They won't even watch to let you die. They won't even watch you die.
Yeah.
They're that heartless.
Yeah.
Or soulless.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a terrible joke.
Oh, and there's the dog again.
Yeah, which almost scared the crap out of me again.
But... Also, I think I see something moving up there.
Oh. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Go.
Hang on, we gotta be careful around the barbed wire.
Yeah, that was a skinwalker. I don't think they can go past this barbed wire.
Well, I've never seen animals acting up, well, other than running from stuff, which are probably demons and ghosts, past the barbed wire.
Yeah,
like, I've seen prairie dogs.
If a skinwalker is morphed into an animal, they can't go on all fours.
Yeah.
Imagine they just morph into a T-Rex, though.
Yeah, then we'd know it's a skinwalker.
Yeah.
Because that'd be way too obvious.
Yeah, and if you ever see... Someone's top. If you ever see someone's top eyelids start twitching, a skinwalker is trying to get into them.
And if it's just like this, and your eyes just kind of twitching,
yeah,
then it's nothing really, like bad. But
yeah, but oh yeah.
Yeah, you might recognize.
I don't think you guys can see this on camera. Dom can't see it because he's not really a spiritual medium. I'm only like 40%. Unlike my friend Charlie, he's 50%. But that window up there glows red.
I see it sometimes. Remember, I can see like blurry blobs.
Yeah.
And there's a window that's two windows over on this building and building over there that glow blue. Yeah, look, there's that window's glowing blue right now.
Oh, yeah, that's like a level 3.
Two. It's a level 2. And then
no,
these...
that's a 3.
True. And these are just little, like, water things. Because it rained a few days ago. This one might not be.
Hold on. Oh, yeah, that's not rain. I should not have sniffed that, and that was a terrible idea. That smelled like horse manure.
But, yeah, you might recognize this area from one of the shorts we did, and over there. Yeah, basically.
We do our ghost hunting videos. We're going to start posting these a lot more.
Yeah, because we've really never posted them. But, yeah, this is the main area. You might have seen over there. That was where we were mostly filming yesterday.
Yeah, but if you ever see an animal walking on its two hind legs...
Here, how about you put
the... Look at its shadow.
Lamp down and I basically show them how the skinwalkers walk, basically.
So basically pretend I'm a rabbit, like back arched And if they hear you or see you or sense you, they'll just go. And then run towards you.
But yeah, and we have, this is just like a flashlight type thing, and that's just a lantern. It just causes light.
Yeah, but if you ever see someone's eyes, just roll here. Back, like, then you should probably run. Unless you know it's a prank.
Yeah. Or they're showing you, like, hey, look what I can do.
Yeah, like that. But if it's, like, the middle of the night and you're, like, out ghost hunting, don't do this at home, by the way, and their eyes go back, run before they come after you and you get possessed. And basically, if one person's possessed, it'll try and possess the person next to it, and it'll basically try and enslave the entire human race.
Kind of like a ripple effect, where, like, if you throw a rock into a river, it's going to blip out and then ripple and ripple and ripple and ripple, called the ripple effect.
Yeah, but if the wind is strong enough, it will... Please don't. if the wind is strong enough, it will basically make huge, giant tidal waves, which is basically what ghosts try to make. But... Let's get back to it.
Yeah. But, oh, I see a glowing dot up there.
Oh, yeah, that's, oh, crap.
Yeah, I see a bunch of blurry blobs. You guys might not be able to see it, but there's a whole bunch of blurry blobs
up
there.
Unless you're a spiritual medium.
Yeah, sometimes cameras can pick up things that humans, A, cannot hear, B, cannot see, but sometimes...
Wait, do we have filters?
I don't think so.
Oh, because, wait, I have an idea.
Hang on, I'm going to end the video really quick. So, goodbye.
Goodbye.